Okay, we're live again after being stopped, and as I was saying, we're the solar panels. All right, our bodies are the solar panels, and again, it's live video stopped. So, but I'm gonna keep pushing that issue, flip it over again, and use whatever it is that they're stopping to my advantage with this. Okay, so let's go, let's try that again. And man, the beauty of life is an ongoing process. That's what we can use. Okay. Live again. Hey, as you all can see, we must be. Let's get together and do what we need to do. All the people here in Little Rock, Arkansas that have skills and the abilities to, who have been in prison, large number of people, been in prison, come out. You know how to grow fruits and vegetables. That is the most powerful thing we have right now. Nothing is more powerful. Let me not say nothing. Most things that we are using, meetings and all of that, don't give us those answers. As the garden, I'm going to use the biblical aspect of our lives. The seed that we are, the Bible, the Christian says, man was put in the Garden of Eden to take care of it in the very beginning. We're the seed, just like a sperm, into the womb. See, we're the seed that goes into the womb to take care of the woman, the family, life, the man, the masculine self. You see how nurturing that is? How we can use that in every aspect? Yet the churches are babbling on about crimes in the community when you all have the exact answer right there. Right behind nurturing, being put in the Garden of Eden to care for it, it says herbs are for the healing of the nation. Right there. Right on point. It says that herbs are for the healing of the nation. Right behind, right next to the Creator put man in the Garden of Eden to care for it. Creator put your spermatozoa into woman so she can be cared for. Most men say, yeah, man's supposed to be the breadwinner. There it is then. Man cannot live off bread alone. He needs plant-based diet. You see? Right there, back to back, the most powerful aspects are being used negatively in the prison industrial complex, but yet positively for all the other people that we're going to try to find. The juvenile detention centers that they have children housed in. I said I was trying to get those closed. And look at what the people in Faulkner County is doing. You have less and less people, children, coming into the juvenile detention center. How? Just being there. And we know churches have been coming to juvenile detention centers for years, haven't they? And look what they've been doing to the children. Look at the feminization that has been going on through the church, through the juvenile detention centers, through the years. That's the truth that we have to accept, people. Yes, you all have been going there for years. And look at the feminization that's been going on, the child molestation, pedophilia that's been going on with the children all this time. You see, and I'm not gonna run from that truth. I'm gonna speak that truth. Cross the earth shall rise again. And what is going on with Faulkner County, those things, less and less people because the mentoring going on. You see, all the things that I have said, these people are wanting to say, well, hey, we're the one doing it. Okay, that's fine. If you want to take the credit for it, no problem. But you know, I placed that on Facebook powerfully. Why do you have $1.5 million building for 34 children and in it bars, concrete and bars building? Well, so these people in that county, that judge, I gotta respect him for him, respect him for doing that. Says, hey, all you got to do is tell these young people you're worth something, and they listen, and they have a chance. Less and less of them are coming back. You see, black people, you see what's going on. Instead of bringing in that, God, the other thing, the feminization of them, telling you, you know, you're part of, you're gay and nothing's wrong with it. There's a problem with that. So we move on with that, move forward with that. And that's the communication that we have to have, that we must use, that we can use. Another aspect of truth, of solving the problems ourselves. And I also listen to the atmospheric pressure that's been being put on the St. Mark's Church. And look at that. I asked you all to put a big garden right there in that corner lot right there. And that would make a huge difference in the lives. Look how many jobs. I don't know if you all know that, but I have the information. I can show you the number of jobs and the money you can make off of that. I have the information. This green thing that's going on, it's been going on in our lives. We've been had that. You know the dollar value in that. Picking cotton, sharecropping, and all of that. The dollar value that they built this country on, the powerful, richest country in the world, that was built based on that. And you all are running from that? So again, I know you may have other plans for that piece of property, but in 3 months' time, in one growing season, you can make a powerful regimen for that area. Less crime will be taken, less bad diet going to those food places on that corner right there next to you all, right there at Hillary Rodham Clinton Library, right down the street. They're giving away food. It is so enjoyable, so powerful a message that the federal funding that goes into that, the seeds that they get, they grow the food and they give it away to the community. You see the benefit in that? And when we talk about what white people are doing, they go to third world countries, right? And they build up gardens and show people how to eat. And they feel like first world people. Like, look what we've done for these third world people. We've given them food and all that. You see how good they feel for doing that? And black people won't even do it. And we have a masterful garden food farmer growing right down in Grady, Arkansas. But people are still saying Mexicans get along better than blacks. That's not true. This brother sells his things to Walmart. He told us in his story that he doesn't sell all of his stuff to Walmart because they get you in that trap and you'll know what to do next. So he has the brain function to bring the billion-dollar industry, the billion-dollar plan that we have already in us, the movement that we need to make, the civil rights movement, the silver trail, the hermaphrodite energy, the antenna that we are, the solar panels that we are. And I'm going to use on the solar panel, show how that works. Remember the Leonard Jeffrey stories, how when they tried to use junior high school students to bring in the our history, to put in the school books for everybody to read about. He said, no, that's not how we're going to do it. So he went and got people from the Indian folks, all of the cultures that they were going to use to put in the books for everyone to read about the cultural differences. And he didn't meet up with them at all. He just communicated with them via telephone, via the computer, and made it happen. And those people became powerful people and said, no, you cannot use this information, because these people know better. They are educated enough, and they use that solar panel that they became as one. And he explained how it worked. He just called them, communicated with them. What do you think about this information that they're putting in about your culture? What do you think about this information they're putting in about your culture? And those people said, no, we have better information. And they became solar panels. They radiated up and became powerful people against all the richest and powerful people who were trying to put it in the books. Houston, Mifflin. Those people who put all the information about school books, and then they tried to make him look bad about putting in a book, The Disuniting of America. He told that story. about how those few people came together. And we have the computers that can do the very same thing. We don't have to get together, have no meetings and all of that. What we have to do is use our solar radiated cells, communication devices that we are, because we're never lost. We're not lost at sea. Okay, the memberships. See, the memberships of using a garden, those ships sailing across the sea, that water, and Detroit, and destroying the children. And see what when destroying the children brings, the mighty, powerful destruction to all the so-called rich, powerful people that we have to use, that we can use. And how long ago did Bill Jefferson do that? They try to make him look bad and all of that. Through cognitive dissonance, the word that he used, and he won the case and got his job back and all that, proving to us that this is how this works. You don't have to get together and have a meeting to see. The meeting can happen in the atmosphere, because that's what's going to make the changes, in the atmosphere. Again, the membership of the Garden of the Christian Moral is the garden. That's the membership. The water sails all over the place. The solar panel that you are, that's it. The eye drops, the hovering, the mustard seed of faith. You see, that is the challenge that we have. And there are people who go around right now and stay. One brother, Terry Wright, I went to school with him. He goes around and helps people put gardens together for old women or old men who don't have food and all that kind of stuff. He goes around and hooks those areas up. And there's other people who do that. But because I went to school and I know about him, he has plans that could start up and help people. We have many people here that could solve all of our problems. Like this thing that they put up downtown, with the computer technology center. Why did you have to spend all that money? We could have took some of those dilapidated houses in the neighborhood, gutted them, structured them where they wouldn't fall, and put in a number of computers, and blam, that would have solved all of the problems that we have. And y'all know through what I'm going through with the helicopter flyby all the time, and that is the audience, the corruption has the audience, right? And what's the other word? I was in the audition. They have the audition and the audience to carry the corruption on forth. You see? And we can stop that. We don't need all of that. Those people follow me around and doing all of that. Listen, we can. That's fine. In the area that they're doing it in, right there on Martin Luther King and Daisy Bay Street, you see? That is a jealousy. That is a jail allows these and ignorance they have within themselves of not being able to rise above being told, being fooled that your nurturing self, you have to be a gay person. You know how to sew, you know how to cook and clean. See, you've been told, oh, that means you're gay. No, it is not. That means you're a human being, you're a nurturing person. And I've shown that. So they're upset, they're just mad at the world because they've been fooled by that. And I haven't, it's a masculine thing to be. The very first people knew how to do that. God designed waterfalls. God designed beautiful flowers. And they all say God is a man and he did this, he did that. Look at all the beautiful, loving things he formulated that would take your breath away. It's so beautiful. You see? So that's what I'm saying. We are the solar panels of the universal order, radiating energy, a tuning fork, again, sends out a message throughout the universe. And again, the story of Lynn Jeffries showed that's an example of he just called those people from all those cultures, said, look at what they're trying to put in the school books to teach our generation. So what do you all think about that? They wrote it back to him. Said, no, this is what really actually happened. This is the most beautiful thing that we have to offer. Look at my beautiful culture. Look at what all of this. And blam, their solar panels that they're made of came to fruition, flowered up out of the desert rocks. You see, like all deserts have are the most, well,